Hey guys, and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I will show you the whole process from this image to this image. I will do the processing in the software Siril and Gimp, and I'll also show you how to install them and how to install the scripts we need for that. As an example image, I use M94, the Croc's Eye Galaxy. Okay, so first of all, we need to install Siril. The link to that is in the description. And the link will bring you to this website, and here you can simply select whichever version you want to use. For me, it is Windows. Once you click there, a setup is being downloaded, and you then simply have to follow the setup, and Siril is installed. We now also need to install scripts. You can find the link to this website in the description. Here we can see the scripts that are already installed. Down here are the other scripts, and we want to install these three scripts, so you can simply click on them and they will download. You now have to copy the scripts we just downloaded and go into your program folder, into Siril, then click on scripts and say paste. So there we go, we now have all three additional scripts in here as well. You will now have to create a folder which you can name Siril, for example. And in there, we now have to put four folders. The first folder is called Biases. The second folder is called Darks. The third one, Lights, and the fourth one, Lights. These four folders are the folders in which we will put our images later. So I made two groups of images, and the first one, we can just go into the camera settings here, was made with an exposure time of 32 seconds and a gain of 250. And the second group is with an exposure of 60 seconds and a gain of 200. And we will now click our way through these images. And you already notice many of these images are blurred. And that's because I do not have an auto guider. And it also was a little cloudy this night. That's why some of the images are pretty bad. So this picture, for example, is very bad, and I'll delete all of the blurred images and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm finished. Unfortunately, I had to delete many pictures, but we're now going to go to the next folder, and here we have another group of pictures, and we'll just click our way through these as well, and I'll delete the blurred ones once more. Alright, I'm finished with deleting the blurred pictures, and I now have to copy all of these and all of these pictures into the lights folder in the Siril folder. However, there is one problem. As you can see, this picture is called 00001. And in the other folder, we have the same file name. So we now need to rename these pictures, and for that we simply select all of these pictures, make a right click and say rename. Now it looks like we would just rename this one picture, but actually we rename all of these. So I just type in something like galaxy. It doesn't matter at all what you type in. And you now see that there's galaxy 1, galaxy 2, galaxy 3, and so on. So we can now say copy. We go into the lights folder and say paste. We then select all of the other pictures, say copy, and we paste them in this folder as well. So then we have it. Now we don't have any problems with the file name, and we can now put all of these pictures into the same folder. Unfortunately, I didn't make any biases, darks or flats, but if you have, you can put your images into these three folders. So now we can open the software Siril, and we first of all have to select the folder in which all our images currently are. So for that we click on this blue button up here and it redirects us to this window. I have already selected it, but you go wherever your folder is which you created. For me it is in Windows, and I click on the Siril folder and I say open. So now we can see in the top it opened the folder Siril. The next step is to run a script. For that we click on scripts, and then you can run whatever script you want to. I will go with without darks, biases or flats. If you do have biases and flats, you can take without dark or without flat depending on what pictures you took. But as I don't have any of these three, I'm gonna go with this script right here. Now I just click on it and the script starts running. Alright, it's now finished and it says it took 2 minutes and 19 seconds. And you might be like, we still don't see an image, and that's because we now need to click on open, and then there is this result. And we can now click on open, and there we have it. We now have our picture here. You see these three channels up here, red, green and blue, and there's also RGB. However, if you want to do something with the picture, you can't do it in this picture, as it says here, only for visualization. If you want to do something with the picture, you have to do it in one of these three channels. And we now have this ugly little edge around here, which we definitely don't want. So we can select something like this, then make a right click and say crop. And we've now cut off the edges and we've got ourselves the part of the picture we actually want. You might be wondering why this picture still is so dark. This is because down here, right now it is on linear, and if we click on auto stretch, we can see the galaxy a lot better. As I did not use any flats, we can now see this three bright spots in the corners, and to get rid of them we can go in image processing and then on background extraction. We can now let the program set all the samples by itself. You can adjust the tolerance. I'll go with something like 0.3, say generate, and now it placed all of these little green dots by itself. I can now say apply. And we can now go over here, close that, let all these points are away, and we can now go back and forth, and we can now see that it didn't actually help a lot, and this whole bright spot from the top right corner was kinda made darker, but on the other hand, on the left side, it got a lot brighter. And we even lost a lot of detail on the galaxy, so that's definitely not what we want to do. So I'll just undo that. Now we'll live with these spots. I have had them in another image as well, and they don't actually make that much of a difference. So it's very hard to get these out of there, but you might be able to with this tool, the background extraction. The next step after the background extraction is the color calibration. For that I use the simple tool and not the advanced tool. So we click on there and we now have to select a background reference. For that you simply have to click and drag and select a part of the image where there are no stars and which is background. So I'll just go this space up here and then hit use current selection and say background neutralization. We now click here, go back and forth, we can now see that there's a huge difference. Next step is the white reference. For that we select a part of the picture which is supposed to be white, and for that I'm just going to select the middle of the galaxy right here and hit apply. Oh, I actually forgot to say current selection. There we go, now it worked. We can now go back and forth and we can see that it's only a very tiny change, but at least it is a change. The next step after the color calibration is the color saturation. For that we have these two sliders, and with the amount we can adjust the strength of the saturation, and with the background factor we can adjust how much the background is being saturated. I would simply leave the background factor on 1 and adjust the amount to around 0.3. We can then hit apply, and we have saturated the picture a little more. Next up, we go to image processing and to ASIN transformation. We now select linear down here, and we now stretch the picture only a little bit. We only stretch it so far that we can see the detail. So in my case, this might be something around the value 9. However, in your case, it can be completely different. We then hit apply and then go to the histogram transformation. Here we can see the histogram of the picture, and we can adjust these two little triangles down here. And we now need to stretch the picture. We now have to be careful that we don't make the picture too bright, and we also don't cut off any information of the picture. For me, these were the best values. However, for you, these values can be totally different. I can now hit apply and close this window. If we want to, we can now also go to image processing and remove green noise. If we hit apply here and close it, and go back and redo it again, we can see a slight change, and I personally think that makes the picture at least a little bit better. We are now finished in Siril, and we hit that button up there. I will name this file Siril, as this is the picture we got from Siril, and I will not make a FITS file, but a TIFF image. So there we go, now hit save. I will use 32-bit, no compression, and I can now hit save. We are now back in the folder Siril, and here is the final result we got from Siril. I can open it, and you will see it. If you wonder what these green dots are in the stars or in the bright points, this is just because of the program I'm using to view these images. This is not actually in the image itself. Now that we are finished in Siril, we have to install the scripts for GIMP. For that, you open this page, which I linked in the video description, and you just scroll down all the way to here, and you click on this Astro Tools file. Then downloads as a text document, so we don't want that, and we click on it and say save as. Then we click on all files and go for .scm and hit save. So now it is also saved as a .scm file, and that's what we want. You now have to figure out where to put these scripts, and for that you click on Edit, then on Preferences, and then we have to scroll down, open this Folders menu, and click on Scripts. And in here I can see where I need to put my scripts. As you can see, I went all the way from my program files to the Scripts folder, and I can now hit Paste, and There we go, we now have the Astro Tools scripts in here as well. We now have to restart GIMP to be able to use the scripts. We can now open our image in GIMP. And to access the scripts we just installed, we click on Filters and then we have this new menu, Astro. There we can click on DSOs aufhellen. This is German and means to brighten the deep sky objects. So if we click on that, it runs for a moment. It's now finished, and over here I can hide this layer and we can see how this brightened the whole image. We can now make a right click and hit flatten image, and we now only have one picture left. The next step is to click on filters, then on Astro, and then Sterne verkleinern, which means the same as make the stars smaller. So if we click on that, it takes a time for a moment. It's now finished, and if we zoom in on one star and we hide this layer, you can see the star got a little bit smaller. You can do this multiple times if you want to. I normally do it like one or two times, but if you want to, you can also do it many times. However, you have to consider that the stars are getting smaller and smaller, and it might look unnatural at some point. I once again hit flatten image, and the next step is to go into colors, then into levels. In here we once again have this kind of histogram, and we can adjust the values here as well. Okay, so these settings right here work pretty well for my picture, and I now hit OK. If you want to, you can now hit colors once more and go into saturation. You can now select the color you want to saturate, or just click on master and you'll saturate all colors at once. You can also split the view, and then you have on the left side your saturated image and on the right side the image that is not saturated. You can also move this line by simply clicking on it and dragging it. I'm going to saturate all of the colors, and to do that you go down here and you hire this value. So if we go to about 20, we can now see the difference, and the blue is a lot more present now. If we go over the star, it's also more saturated now. You'll have to work out the value that fits your image the best. For me, I think 20 is pretty good, so I'll hit OK. I can now export it by going to File and Export As, and I'm going to name it GIMP, as that is the result I got after processing it with GIMP. I'll leave all of these settings on default and hit Export. This is the final result, and I'm actually very happy about how it turned out. I personally think it's stunning that you can create a picture with so much information from many pictures with only little information. I hope this tutorial helped you process your own deep sky images, and if you still have any questions left, just ask them in the comments. Clear skies.